Night, her uncle often warned, was when danger was most present. But Quill preferred the stories of the magical creatures that woke to protect the forest. Thanks to her new friend, Quill had saved priceless grains from the hourglass. She raced to the door of the cottage she shared with her uncle, hoping once he saw her discovery, he'd lose himself in tales of its legend. Uncle Argus was watching the evening light dim when Quill burst through the front door of their cottage.
Uncle! Uncle, there's something you have to see!
Out past the...
Quill's hands trembled as she showed him the glass.
What is it?
She asked. A look of panic spilled over her uncle's stoic exterior.
Where did you find this?
Roared Uncle Argus. Quill had never seen her uncle so shaken.
Just west of the clearing,
she explained. And as soon as I picked it up, something started helping me. Uncle Argus followed her motion.
A reader? With you, here, right now? Quill, what you found is very powerful and very dangerous,
he said with great concern.
If I could take this burden from you, I would. But this reader has chosen.
Thank you.
Even with the moon full and bright, I must go right away.
Quill pressed. Where are you going? I can help. We can help.
No, he snapped. They'll find you and tear you apart. I have to go alone. It is for your own safety and for everyone here in the clearing.
His long, heartfelt hug told her he was heading for danger.
I'll be back before midnight. Until I return, I need your word you will not leave the clearing with that glass. Promise me, Quill.
I promise, she said reluctantly, wondering where her uncle was going so deep into the night.